Good morning, everybody. It's day two from Harmony of the Sea. We're at Coco Key. Come on in, check it out. Such a cool view in the morning, guys. Look like we had some rain here recently. See the skies, let's see what happens. I can kind of feel like the sun coming out and see it. So we're getting ready to have some breakfast. We may try, there's this little cafe down here in Central Park. I believe it has breakfast. So we may go over there and see about maybe trying some breakfast there because it's so close to our room. And then we're gonna get off the ship. We're gonna go to Coco Key. We got a really fun day ahead. So come on, let's go have some fun. A very happy birthday to my son, Jake, who is 11 years old today and he's skipping school. How's it feel to be 11, Jake?
Yeah.
Thumbs up.
Yeah.
So here we are, guys, again. I know I've been showing a lot of the Central Park, but isn't it so awesome? You can see it's some rain earlier this morning, but looks like it's trying to get a little bit sunny out there. Let's head over to Park Cafe. I'll give you guys a little tour, and we'll go get some breakfast. So guys, as we enter in to the Park Cafe, this is really cool. Something that definitely was not Independence of the Sea. All kinds of stuff here. So you got your oatmeal and hot milk here. Fruits. Look at those fruit cups, man. Awesome. Oh, May's gonna love this. Guaranteed she's gonna want one of those. So, you know what I'm loving about this? I can tell you right now what's cool about this is you could grab some of that and just bring it to your room, right? You got breakfast sandwiches. Morning. All kinds of toppings. Look at these burritos, guys. Very cool.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, guys. How you doing, guys?
Welcome on board.
Yes. Look at this. Oh, you guys got it all in here. This is like a secret spot. I'm not going to tell anybody about this. Look at all this, guys. These guys are awesome this morning, man. Look at everything you can pick here. So, one second, I'll be back because we're getting an announcement. So, guys, as we continue on, you can get those bagels, sandwiches, all kinds of nice toppings. And as you come down the end here, a couple things I want to show you. Look at these awesome jams, man. And I'm not talking about the music. Those are good jams, too. But look at all kinds of stuff here. Cool, man. And then, of course, we have some this is like a hidden little treat. Oh, and I love this. Another one on this side, so you can just grab this too. You guys can see the seating inside. You got your beverage service right here. This is all included in your cruise. All of the things in here are included, including the beverages. And then outside here, guys, check this out. Beautiful place to enjoy our breakfast this morning, Jake. Happy birthday. And I got a English muffin sandwich. Couple pastries. I'm gonna start with that. We'll just eat our breakfast. We'll let you know if it was any good. And we're gonna continue on our day. Mother Nature, which is neat here. Check this out, guys. Got like a roof here. So you can sit under here even when it is a little bit rainy. Captain did say showers on and off today. So we're gonna have a little bit of rain on Coco Key. So guys, I did upgrade a little bit. I went back in and got one of these. Roberta just has a little croissant with, it looks like cream cheese. May's got a breakfast burrito. Oh wow, that looks delicious. With some cheese. She's got some, there's some of those jams I was talking about with some awesome bread and some fruit. I got some coffee. This might become one of my new favorite little spots because our room's just right over there in the corner as I showed you guys earlier. We are loving this ship. Thank you for joining us for breakfast. We're gonna enjoy our breakfast. Give you a quick just kind of summary how it all was. And then we're gonna probably start getting ready to head out to Coco Key on a little bit of a rainy day. So guys, I've noticed a lot yesterday and this morning I've caught myself. I keep saying, all right, so next thing we're gonna do is this and this, and it kind of changes a lot. So I just wanted to turn it back on because I know I just said, oh yeah, we're on our way probably to the beach or whatever, but we're still here because look, I got more. I got the, I went in and got a burrito. It's like a vegetable breakfast burrito. Roberta got one too. But all the other food we had here was good. Roberta, I think it was good. What do you think?
Food is good.
Yeah. Is it the best? Maybe not top shelf, but good for a quick snack in the morning for sure, right? If you want to beat the crowd, you mentioned something, Roberta.
It's beat the crowd and the peace, which is very quiet here.
It's peaceful, yeah.
Yeah, you hear birds.
I do hear birds. I don't know if they're piping in the sound of birds or if birds are actually living here. I wouldn't be surprised if birds were living here in Central Park. It's all live trees, and it's very possible that they are living in here. But I think Roberta made a good point that if you're in this kind of, if your room's close here and you just kind of want a more chilled, relaxed, beautiful scenery view here at Central Park, guys. Yes, it's not as many options as Windjammer, but I think the food is just as good as Windjammer for sure. So I think now we're going to finally finish our breakfast. When I was sitting over there having breakfast, guys, I noticed this awesome, like, this is really cool because it's got this roof over it and these really comfortable seats. And as you can see, this is where the Park Cafe is. So Roberta and May is right there. And I just had to come over here with Jake, celebrating Jake's birthday all day today, Jake. Oh, and wow, I didn't even know that. This is why I love cruising. You come over here, look down there, there's a promenade deck, Jake.
Yeah.
Oh, look how cool that is. Wow, look, not many people there. Jake, what are you thinking of Central Park, man?
This is very cool.
Isn't it awesome? Let's just have a seat here for a minute, Jake. Oh, I love it. I'll show you the view of what Jake and I are looking at. Look at that. And up there, the water slides, Jake. Jake, you love the green and the yellow, the Brazilian flag colors.
Yeah.
Oh, God, guys, this is so great. It's just a little after 8, Jake, and I'd say that you're having a fantastic birthday so far,
yeah,
man.
Yeah.
But, Jake, don't forget, I'm going to tell you something, and I'm going to tell everybody out there something, Jake. We're celebrating your birthday every day this week, man.
Yeah.
We're just celebrating life. We live our lives. I think one thing that we do, Jake, right? Me, you, and Mom all the time is that we just love to do all kinds of stuff.
Yeah.
And that's what we do. And that's why we're so happy for you guys to join us on our awesome cruise vlogs. Please take a moment. Hit that subscribe button. Jake, you know YouTube really well. Where's the subscribe button? Is it like right there? Boom. For Jake's birthday. Boom. All right, guys. I just did want to show you this. It's really cool. I'm going to do a whole tour to Central Park at some point, and I'll put it on a separate vlog. So what we'll do is we'll run our day one, day two. I'm going to do every day, vlog every day, and then I'll start running out some of the tours and things like that. So that sounds like a very good idea. So Jake is, for his birthday, he's vlogging right now. Nice big piece of artwork as we're going down, guys. So cool. We're heading down to go to Coco Key.
Gunway, please.
Here we are. Oh, we can get towels right here if we need it. So guys, we're here on, it's deck 3 to get outside. You can grab beverages before you go over to Coco Key, which is really nice. And then you're gonna exit right down this way. You can grab your towels right here. On the island, there are no towels, but you can check towels out. And bring them with you before you leave the ship right here. I'll show you guys. What you do is you just give your cabin number and you can take its unlimited amount, you know, I'm sure within reason, but they never really question how many you need. And we're gonna grab a couple Powerades. Actually, I'll take a sugar-free Red Bull, maybe a couple waters and a Powerade. Oh yeah, we're going to have some fun. All aboard 3:30. So looks like they extended it. We were originally supposed to leave at 3, so that's cool. They gave us a little bit extra time. And now we're going down to level 2 to get off the ship. Guys, make sure you bring in that Sea Pass card with you. You definitely need that to scan to get off the ship. And we do have two Royal Caribbean. So guys, this is Royal Caribbean's private island. So only Royal Caribbean ships will be here. We actually have Explorer of the Seas here as well. Look at that, right on the side of us, guys. Isn't that such a cool view? There's the Harmony, and then on this side, the Explorer. So cool. It doesn't look terrible out.
I will tell you one thing. It's a lot cooler here than it is in Central Florida where I live. It feels great out here. Fresh air. Beautiful breeze coming in between these ships. Let's head over to Perfect Day. Coco Key. Celebrating Jake's birthday. So here we go, guys. Perfect Day. Coco Key. I think our game plan is... we want to try to get to the Oasis Lagoon right away because there's two ships here. And there's a lot of people you can see already. So I got a feeling it's going to be difficult to find a spot. But we'll give it a shot and we'll find out. In the lagoon, you can just kind of walk straight in through. And that's how you can get to the lagoon. They also have this huge map, or they have paper maps you can get as well, which shows you the whole entire island. And you can ask the workers on the island, like, for information. That's what we did last time. Today the wind's pretty calm. Last time we were here back in April, it was a really windy day, and he suggested to go to South Beach, and he was right. We got to South Beach and it was really more relaxed, not a lot of wind. But today we're gonna hit some of the other spots, probably down towards this end that we didn't get the chance to do last time. Oh, we got a dance party. Looks like a band getting ready to set up. So a lot of party here early in the morning on Coco Key. And definitely gonna try to show you some of the things we didn't get to last time. And this is the awesome, awesome map I was talking about. So we're right here, right? You are here. And we're gonna head right to this Oasis Lagoon. Last time we kind of were in this area, which we liked because we were right near all these things that we enjoy to do. So let's go check it out, guys. May, what do you think so far of the island? Isn't it beautiful?
Beautiful.
Beautiful.
Beautiful place.
Yes, it is.
I love it.
Yes, and we love it. Jake loves it, and he loves playing on the playgrounds here and everything. Definitely still at 11, Jake. You can enjoy all that. I guess we're not gonna have a problem finding a spot, guys. That's what's cool about getting here, and it's not even that early.
Yeah,
it's been a couple hours since we've been able to get off this ship. Look at this, there's spots everywhere. I gotta tell you, the last time we were here, we did not have all of these open areas. Look at this awesome spot we found. We got an umbrella, we got four, kind of like right in a row, a little bit of space around us. And guys, let me turn around and show you. There is the Oasis Lagoon. Roberta, what time is it actually in the morning?
Now it's 9:15.
It's 9:15. And you may think that's early, but when you come to an island like that, it can get late, right? If everybody was off the ship. But we beat a lot of people off the ship today, which I am so thankful for. Guys, take a look at this. This place is great. All fresh water. They say it's the biggest freshwater pool in all the Caribbean. Look at that. And of course, they do have life jackets, free to use. And last time I was here, I noticed these awesome things if you need accessibility. I love these chairs for anybody that utilizes a wheelchair. These big tires, you can go right in the sand with these things. This is awesome. And I believe those are also complimentary to you. So we're gonna just start having fun, man. Love it, love it, love it. Isn't this pool just so awesome, guys? Look at this. And my advice is, especially days like this when there's two cruise ships here, definitely are gonna want to try to get here early like we did. That way you can find the seating you want if you're planning on coming to the Oasis Lagoon, which is totally included in your cruise fare. No extra cost at all to utilize this awesome big pool. Check it out, man. Swim up bars over that way. Let's go over there and check that out. One thing I want to tell you is these lifeguards right here are excellent, because we just saw them go to work. There was a kid, you know, as we were coming up here by the, you can see this is the swim up pool bar right here. As we were coming up by the pool bar, you know, the lifeguard, you know, blew the whistle, jumped in, started swimming out. There was a kid actually, you know, I don't want to say he was, you know, at the point of drowning, but he was really struggling in the water. And that lifeguard jumped right in and really recognized that. So his name was Eric, by the way, the lifeguard. So hats off to Eric if you're watching his vlog, man. Great job in being able to recognize that. So you guys with kids, that's why it's important, too, for those life vests. Make sure that they have those life vests if needed. But here's a swim-up pool bar. Check this out. This is all so awesome here, guys. And if you have your beverage package, you can utilize this. Because Coco Key is part of Royal Caribbean, so your beverage package works here. No extra charge while you're on Coco Key. Awesome. And then, of course, if you don't have the beverage package, you can still, you know, go and then use your C card and pay for it. So there it is. Woo. Party time early. Yeah, it's 10 o'clock somewhere, right? Yeah.
I started at 8.
There you go. There you go. See, everybody having a good time. So Roberta started out with a mock pina colada. Then we have a strawberry mock with pina colada. Look at those. Those look delicious. Enjoy. Roberta, how is it? Go ahead. Give it a shot. Are you... Let me try. Love it. So I did get, I can't remember who asked me this question, but there was a comment on our Coco Key or one of our cruise vlogs about what do you guys use to carry your phones and your sea passes around when you're on the islands. We use these awesome pouches. They're waterproof. Check it out. So you can submerge them in the water. Your phone fits in there. You can put your cards, your sea cards in there. And on Coco Key, we don't bring our passports. It's their private island. Although, when we do go to other islands, we will bring our passports. So I think it's about time we go check out some salt water in the beach. And actually, just to show you, this is a nice little area. Remember I told you last time we went to the South Beach? So you can go down this way. You can walk. And Oasis Lagoon is where we were. But we want to go definitely check out like Chill Island today, Chill Beach. We want to check out Harbor Beach. Last time we did go to the market. So we're going to go check out more of this area. This time we're here at Coco Key. We did briefly last time, but today we're going to focus a lot on that. I just noticed these two guys. Remember I was showing you these chairs? They actually have them also for younger kids. Oh, this is just amazing. I love that Royal Caribbean is doing this. This is something that means a lot to me. And really the accessibility here. So you can really enjoy yourself. That is awesome, man. So guys, as we're on our way to the beach, I wanted to just quickly show you here, Splash Away Bay, just like on the cruise ships, the kids area they call Splash Away Bay. Also here on Coco Key, check it out. Now this is a lot of fun. Jake definitely, he's 11, but come on. I'm 48 and I'm gonna go and have a lot of fun in here. I do show this also on the vlog from Independence of the Sea. Check it out, guys. We have May, who also known as Vovó. That's how you say grandma in Portuguese. May and Jake are gonna have a race down the slide. Look at Vovó following all the directions from the lifeguard. She's ready. Jake has got a, looks like he says, there's no way my Vovó is going to beat me today. She might have the weight advantage, but Jake has the young advantage of age. Go! And Jake with the false start. And May, down they go. This is why we love cruising, guys. So here we are, guys. We're gonna head down towards the Chill Island, Chill Beach, the market, all the cool things over this side. As you can see, this is cool, man. Over here is Captain Jack's. Again, they have food, and they also, you can also use your drink package in there as well. Look how awesome that is, guys. There's a Harbor on the Sea over on the left side, and then Explorer of the Seas there on the right side. Wow, look at that. So we're gonna go over here to the beach, right? That look at, just the ocean, pure ocean. But what's cool is you can see here, guys. Oh, look, we got some fish down there, man.
Pure ocean.
I'm not sure what kind of fish those are, but they look like needles. Maybe they're called needlefish or something. There's quite a few of them. But what's cool is check this out. This water comes in this way. And then as you come over on this side, they built this nice cool lagoon, which we'll also go and check out. There's Skipper's Grill. Guys, as we head over to the beach, you're gonna see here, it's like the island market. I did include it a lot in the last time I was here in the vlog. So there's a lot of these little shops here. As you can see all throughout here, it's really cool the way it's set up. There's a cruise ship's looking through. This is just a cool place. Look at these awesome hammocks. You can just, now I know why they call it Chill Island. Look at this, paradise, guys. Look at all under here. Oh, wow, love that. And plenty of seats still available. Lots of umbrellas here, guys, all included. Looks like they got a bar here again, be able to use your drink package. Wow, this is just unbelievably awesome. So here's an area where you can rent lockers, guys. And looks like you can get your snorkel equipment. I know they have rental for snorkeling. Really cool. So yeah, we're right here. And the beach, again, just right over to the left. So this is where you're gonna wanna go for, I didn't know they had lockers. Not sure the price, let me see if I can find out. So I found out the good thing is the lockers are free. They do have several of them here. The bad news is it's first come, first serve. So you don't even go on the app. There's no reservation system. You come off the ship, you go to the locker, it's free. You use it for the time you're here. I just actually said they're all full right now. So that's what I would do. I would just come and then say, hey, are there any available? And then you'll be able to tell if you can use them or not. So I didn't realize that. And you can see people definitely using them. Cool. Ah, guys, this water is really, really warm. Much warmer than it was in April. Although, I didn't come on this side of the island. I'll be able to tell when I get into the lagoon, because we went in the lagoon there back in April. It was cold, but check it out, man. Check out the views. There's another private island over there. I think, I don't know, somebody leave me a comment. I think that's the MSC island over there. Not 100% sure. I believe it is. Not positive, but anyway, you can see those are those family cabanas over there, like the $1,200 cabanas. Look at that, a lot of people now. Cool, man. So again, you can kind of see the beach, all the umbrellas, all the chairs, all included here on Chill Island. Looks like another bar area here. What's cool is this is kind of new to me because I didn't check this out. So again, bit of a line now, though. You can see a line now to get to the bar. So I do see the servers are walking around. If you are sitting down, they will bring you your drinks as well. And looks like we're coming out here at the market. This is the market, all the different little shops. So guys, remember we were up on the bridge, now we're over here in the lagoon. Oh, looks like they got the zip line coming right down here. Doesn't look like it's operating. No, either that or just nobody's doing it. So that's neat. You can actually start there with the zip line and zip line right over this little lagoon area. And there's Skipper's Grill. We'll be having some lunch there. And I would like to report that the water is absolutely beautiful. Much, much warmer than in April. So we found a great place to eat our lunch right here underneath the umbrella here. Right behind us, you can get all our food. We're gonna go ahead and get our food. I'm gonna come back, show you what we get. We're gonna try it all out right now.
Black bean rice, May.
Wow. French fry.
French fry and salad.
Awesome.
Fruit.
May says the fruit's excellent. Oh, look at Roberta. Oh, they do have potato salad. I didn't notice that last time I was here.
By the salads.
Corn on a cob, and these tacos are awesome,
steak,
guys.
And chicken.
Steak and a chicken taco, and they make these fresh, by the way.
Yeah, this is a corn tortilla, this one.
Oh, wow, awesome. So guys, I built this awesome cheeseburger. I got some onions, I got some mushroom and more onions, I got pickles, I got tomato, I got some ketchup and mayo and some potato salad. Can't wait to try this. So Jake is having a birthday burger, just a nice classic cheeseburger with some ketchup and fries. Jake, how is the cheeseburger?
Pretty good.
Pretty good. I have tried my burger I have tried my potato salad. Both good. Definitely will say they're both good. I really like the potato salad. I like that better than the burger. And Roberta, how about you? Over here chowing down on your tacos.
Potato's good.
Potato salad's good, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
And May says that she prefers her own rice and beans, which she makes, which I will vouch for because they are excellent. Roberta, how's the tacos? Good?
Good.
Roberta's saying good. Guys, check out, I now have a steak taco. So awesome. I put rice, black beans, sour cream, salsa, and a little bit of lettuce. I'm gonna try this out for you now. Roberta and I both decided that the steak taco we thought was better than the chicken, and the flour tortilla was easier to eat. The corn one really crumbled, right, Roberta?
Yeah. So it was good, but it's harder to
eat. But we all did enjoy our lunch. I'd say overall, Roberta here had a great lunch, and look at just a great, beautiful view. So I know I keep saying and refer back to the other vlog, but as we are walking through, I will give you a quick little tour. So here's all your taco stuff, guys. Over here, look, salsa bar, all your goods, all the toppings you want for your tacos, and you can see they make them fresh right there. As we continue on, guys, I'm gonna show you just quickly, Cubans, which I had last time, which is pretty good. Oh, they had a ribeye steak sandwich. Really good. Continue on over here. And again, you can see that, you know, there's so much, there's no line. So you can just kind of walk up, grab it. And there was plenty of seats. And they also have salads. Last time I was here, I missed this. So I don't know if it was here last time or if it's new. So you got your potato salad, which I had, which was good. Just like a green salad, Caesars, and then the tomato cucumber salad. And over here, guys, they have all the grilled foods. Yeah, you know, this is Meddling World. I gotta show you. I just couldn't help it. I had to show you the food. You got your rolls, you got your cheeseburger, hot dogs, corn on the cob, barbecue chicken, french fries, and it just repeats itself as you go down the line. Really, really cool, so you don't have to wait forever to get your food. And plenty of seating. We left down by the beach there on that dock. It was tons of tables still open. So even with the two cruise ships here, I was a little concerned. Primetime lunch right now, but you can see it's not too bad. How could I forget dessert? I'm so sorry, guys. Oh, brownies and cookies. And of course they have ice cream, as Jake's just having the best birthday of his life. And you gotta eat the ice cream quick. Jake, is it true you gotta eat it quick?
Uh-huh.
You can see it's kind of like a milkshake in a cone. So we're back here at the biggest freshwater pool in all the Caribbean, Oasis Lagoon. And I just kind of want to show you, look at the difference now compared to this morning. You can see now a lot more people, especially around that swim up bar, totally packed. So it definitely, guys, it pays to come earlier. We're gonna actually just swim a little bit and then we're gonna head back to the ship. So let's enjoy. As we're getting ready to head, guys, back to Harmony of the Sea, one more cool view of that. Look at that tall water slide circles down. Plus this awesome ship here for kids to play on, or big kids like me. Man, we had a lot of fun today on Coco Key. And it's only 1:30 in the afternoon, and we are heading back on to that big beauty because there's more fun to have today. So come and join us for the rest of our awesome adventure. And I would like to say, no rain at all. So it was a beautiful day. What a bright sunny day. Back down here now on the promenade deck 5, because we're gonna go hit up the Promenade Cafe. But guys, take a look at, Royal has just some awesome art. This is like a head. Really cool. And it spins around. So it's supposed to be a head. At some point it will turn into a head. Oh, there you go, kind of. His nose, his mouth, there he is. That's pretty cool, man. So we're down here. It's about 2 o'clock now. We got back from Coco Key and we're just gonna hang out the rest of the day. We got dinner coming up. We got, I believe we're going to see Grease tonight. So come and hang out with us for the rest of the day.
Got a little tuna sandwich here, guys. The tuna avocado sandwich. Jake's got the chocolate bar. We're gonna chow down on these. And of course, you can never have enough Pellegrinos. Awesome. Roberta went over to Sorrento's Pizza. She got Brazilians, I can't understand. They put ketchup on pizza. Artichoke salad. Jake, again, living his best life on his birthday. More pizza. I will show you guys Sorrento's later when I go over and I get some pizza. How is the pizza, guys? Roberta? It's good? Jake?
It's approved.
Sorrento's approved. Guys, up here on Deck 6, Vitality Cafe. You can come up here and you can get, they have, if you have your refreshment package, fresh smoothies, guys. Check it out. All these different beverage options back here, too. They got some granola bars. Oh, ginger. Look at all these different kind of things. Banana bread. Ooh. Not so bad. We're gonna get a couple smoothies. So guys, check this out. My man, Rostin? Rostin, right here, guys. He's making a smoothie. He's putting some protein in there. He's gonna put some blueberries and banana. And this is awesome. This is up on Deck 6 Forward in the spa. Man, this is awesome. Included with your refreshment package. I can't wait to try this. Thank you, my friend. Got the smoothie right here. Austin hooked it up. Let's try it. Again, the protein, the blueberry, the banana. Mmm. And whole milk. It's really good. Austin, this is good, man. You hooked it up.
Thank you very much, sir.
So when you're coming on Army AC, you come on up here, you see my man Austin, and he is gonna hook you up. So Roberta's trying this smoothie. How do you like it?
That's good.
It's really good. And Rostin, I already told him we're gonna be good friends by the end of the ship with Rostin because yeah, we just found another hidden gem here on Harmony of the Seas. Hit that subscribe button right there.
He said that's the spot. He spot his work, so
yeah. Yeah. Awesome. Awesome. So it's 3:30 is all aboard. It is right now 3:30. So, well, it's like 3:27. So I just kind of wanted to come here to the aft because I'm curious to see, you know, take one last really nice look at Coco Key. And of course, let's see if there's people still coming onto the ship. Now, there's two ships. I'm not sure what time the Explorer of the Seas, I think, was the name of the other one. Sorry for the wind, guys. But let's just have a look. Oh, wow. Look how beautiful it is, man. Couldn't help myself, guys, as I walked by over here, mini bites, as they like to call it, on the starboard side. I had to grab, I got some like Italian meatballs, a quesadilla, some nachos, some guac. I mean, isn't this why we cruise? To eat, to enjoy, to have a really good time. And we are now leaving Perfect Day Coco Key. Bye, Coco Key. Bye, Explorer of the Seas. See you guys. Some nice views as we leave. I'm still so curious. I think it's the MSC. I don't know. Could be Norwegian. I have no idea. Just take a look as we say goodbye. Everybody waving here. Oh, no, that's the chill life. That guy right there sitting on that chair. It might be, looks like a crew member almost, just kind of hanging out down there. And here we are, guys. I'm heading back. We're actually on deck 11, but look, I can kind of show you where our room is. It's right there. It's Maze Conga on the chair.
So our room's right there, which is so cool, because now you can really see here that there's no balcony on the side of us. And I haven't, the room on the other side, I haven't heard anybody there. And I was a little concerned because we had that adjoining room. Now, I know it's only been a night. So our room is actually adjoined with another room. We did meet the family there. They were really nice, but haven't heard a sound out of them either. So far, so good. Like I said, it's been a night. But we're going to go clean up, shower up. Beautiful, fun day at Coco Key. And again, on the pool deck, Jake is living his best life on his birthday. He's gone on like every water slide 50 times. The pools, just having a lot of fun. So time to clean up and see what's next on our adventure, day two. So guys, we are here in the Rising Tide Bar now. This is the one that starts here in a promenade deck, as you can see. May, are you excited to go up?
Yes.
I don't know if I believe her or not. Roberta is. Jake. So we're just gonna check it out. You can see these big like columns, and you go up, and then you come out in Central Park up there. Really cool, guys. So we're gonna go ahead. We're gonna order some mocktails. We'll show you what we get and then take a look. Let's see what the view looks like now, okay? And then we'll have another view when we get
over the top. All right, what can I get for you to drink?
So this is really cool because we were trying to figure out what we could get that didn't have alcohol. And the waitress here, she brought it over, so zero proof. There's several different ones here. And then down here, Roberta, look. Sodas and energies, so we can get any of these. And then juice. So this is really, really nice. So there's a lot of choices here, guys. If you're using your regular refreshment package and you don't want to have alcohol, you can still come in here and enjoy a nice drink. And we're just relaxing a little bit after a busy day, as you guys have been watching vlog day two. Just want to chill and enjoy ourselves and loving an elevator. So May, she's gonna get the watermelon mint lemonade. That sounds excellent. Roberta, which one are you gonna go with?
The blueberry.
All right.
Mojito, I guess.
Mojito. And then Jake's getting a Coke. And I'm going with a Bloody Mary without the vodka. So a mock Bloody Mary. So we're gonna get our cocktails. We're gonna enjoy them. And we're gonna go up. Wow, guys, would you look at that? There's the watermelon with the mint, right? Wow, that just looks, it looks pretty. That's what it looks like. The mock Bloody Mary. Roberta, look at this. Can you try a sip of that for us, please, Roberta? I gotta see what this tastes like. Or I gotta know. Go ahead. Roberta's trying the mojito. What do you think?
It's good. It's refreshing.
Let me try, because I'm really, really curious. Look, I can't even, I gotta try it. That is really nice. So Roberta, it's kind of funny, right? So we're at the Rising Tide Bar, which has scheduled departures and arrivals, right? So when you're here, you're departing and you have an arrival time for deck 8. We have a delay. A departure delay due to one of the guests had to actually go to guest service because their C pass wasn't working properly. So the bartender announced that there'll be a delay in us, I guess, going up here. So we are moving. You guys can see, remember where guest service was? Now we're almost up to deck 6, the Schooner Bar. And now you can really start to see that we're almost all the way up to 8. And Roberta, it's been what, about 5 minutes? So I'd say it probably takes maybe 15 minutes to get all the way up.
Yeah.
From the bottom to the top. Not exactly sure, I'm guessing. Give or take. But pretty cool. So as soon as we get up top, I'll show you guys. It's pretty neat though. So guys, look how close now. We made it. We're up on the Central Park. And one thing, Roberta, right, is you can still stay in. It's not like, you know, you come in and then you gotta leave. So we are, because we've been in here for a while.
But you can still hang out in here and go all the way back down to 5 if you wanted. So,
and go up again.
And go back up again. You can just go up and down all day. And just like that, the rising tide bar. And look, this is with school, guys, so you can see. It tells you what time it'll be departing, which is right now 7. No, actually, what time is it, Roberta? Not quite 7, almost 7. So it's like every half an hour. So pretty fun, pretty cool. Salud. And here we are, Jake's. We're ready. Jake, are you ready for your birthday dinner tonight?
Yeah.
Yes, he is. Roberta, are you ready?
Yes.
May?
Yes.
We got the whole crew spinning you around, making you dizzy on Medlin World. Guys, so we came a little early for dinner tonight, and we got lucky because we're supposed to come at 8:15, but they let us come at 7, kind of. Hello. We'll talk about it in a minute. So we got our bread. Awesome. We have, tonight we have a hero and Nadi. And we've met them both. They're awesome guys. And so we came a little early. They did accommodate us, which was great because of what happened last night. We had reservations for that aqua show that we had on day one. But the reservation system is, it's more of an honor system than anything. So tonight they said, you know what? Come on in early. That way you'll have plenty of time to get to your show tonight, which was very helpful. So we appreciate that. And just a little after 7, so we have plenty of time to get to the 10 o'clock show, which is going to be Greece. So we're going to get some food and we'll give a full review. Look what Jake got for his birthday from our waiter tonight. Our assistant waiter, Nadi, recommended the Miami Vice mocktail with the maraschino cherry on top. Jake, how's that look, man?
It looks good.
Awesome. By the way, I think, you know, we do have, I think, reservations in this main dining room 6 out of the 7 nights. But I think we're kind of interested. Tomorrow night, we're thinking maybe we might just try the Windjammer. Right, Roberta, you're thinking?
Yeah, I think so.
Just to see what it's like.
Just change a little bit.
Yeah. And then also we did make a reservation for lunch at one of the specialty restaurants, so not quite yet. That I think is day 6, so we're gonna try lunch in one of the specialty restaurants. I believe the Italian, Jamie's Italian, for lunch, so that'll be coming up in the next few vlogs. But we're just enjoying, we're relaxing. We finally, I think, have settled in on our cruise and we're realizing that this is a whole week long. You know, we've been through one night. We have 6 more whole nights to go and plenty to show you guys. So we're on ocean time now, I think. May could hardly wait, guys. May could hardly wait. She's got the Greek salad and she's gonna get a little olive oil with it as well. Look at these nice shrimp cocktail, guys. Jake, what do you got there, Jake?
Mac and cheese,
French fries. But I think Roberta, I think you hit the jackpot.
That does look good.
Little pork tacos? Are you kidding me?
Even though I had tacos today, but I couldn't resist.
I'm jealous. I should have got those. Roberta, how were those tacos?
It's good.
Really good, huh?
It's very soft. It's bread.
Yeah.
It tastes very good, but it's like bread. It's not it's not like a regular shell or like a.
Awesome.
It's very good. It's spicy.
And as you guys can see, mine was great, man. I love shrimp cocktail. I don't eat a lot of seafood because Roberta's allergic to it. So when we do go out to eat or something, I have it quite a bit. And I had 8 shrimp. They weren't huge, but they were really good. Loved the sauce with it. And May, she's still eating her salad, but she said it was good. It's a Greek salad. You can't go too bad with it. She's giving me the nod. So Greek salad was good. So all the appetizers tonight, I'm going to say very good. Very good appetizers. I'm a little jealous now. May has that tiger shrimp with the rice and the veggies. That looks great. I got the chicken corn on blue. I thought it was like maybe a baked potato with the french fries. It's fine. A little bit of vegetables. Jake with the classic chicken fingers and fries celebrating his birthday. Roberta, what did you get?
I got the steak.
Oh, she's got the steak.
with yeah. that tomato and asparagus and a baked potato.
Sour cream, huh? For the potato, sour cream?
No.
No. Enjoy your meal.
And this is our awesome waiter right here.
Yes. Hi, how are ya? I'm from Bali, Indonesia.
Yeah, thank you very much.
He's awesome. From Bali, Indonesia. Awesome, guys. We're going to dig in. I actually just got back. I ran to the room to get Jake some Dramamine. I think not really so much his stomach, but said it was hurting a little. But the ship is pretty stable. He's just beat up. He's exhausted. Had a long day. But we're going to go ahead and dig in now.
I'm going to show you guys. That does look good. Look, you can see it oozing out. That cheese there with the ham in there on the chicken cordon bleu. I didn't know it would be kind of like breaded like that. The chicken is good, guys, but the french fries and the vegetables definitely both below average. The vegetables, to me, they're bad. They're not even good. I don't even want to eat them. French fries, so-so. But the chicken is good. I'm liking the chicken. Roberta is going good on her steak, Diane. What do you think, Roberta? How is it? Roberta's giving me a thumbs up. May?
It's good.
May's good, Roberta's good, mine, the chicken is good, but the rest not great. And Jake, he's again little exhausted, as you can see. Jake, how was your birthday, by the way? He's tired. He will not make the show tonight, I don't think, but Roberta and I will for sure. I think what's gonna happen is May and Jake, they're both pretty tired from a long day. They probably go back to the room, and Roberta and I will definitely go review Grease.
Sing a birthday song for Jake. I love Jake. He's
gonna get up for Jake.
On count of three. 1, 2, 3.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jake. Happy birthday to you.
Take a picture. Nice, Jake. What do you say, Jake?
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Now, anytime somebody does that for your son, for your daughter, for your family member, that's good. That's great service right there. Love that those guys did that. These guys are professional, as he said, from Bali. It was funny because I was talking to him. So the head waiter and the assistant, both from Bali, and his uncle also was working on the ship. So a lot of, he told me the cruise industry is a lot of people from Bali that work in the cruise industry. So they work the contract 7 months working on the ship every day, and then you're off for 2 months and then you come back. So pretty cool. Jake, what'd you think of that?
Wow.
And how's the cake?
It's good.
It's good?
He's already had some. Oh, it looks really good. Hey, tomorrow I'm going to tell him it's my birthday. May's learning. She hasn't dug in yet before I got to put it on the vlog, guys. Tiramisu for Roberta and May. That looks really good. Wow. And guys, check out mine. Across the table we go. Trace de Leche cake. Look at that. That looks really good. This dessert actually looks real nice. We are just loving life tonight. I feel like I'm so happy to be on this ship. I'm so happy. It's a 7-night cruise, and I still have 6. I've only gone through 1 night of those 7, and I'm just so excited. And I can't wait to vlog it all for you guys. That one, that was the best one I've had so far for sure. The Trace de Leche cake. It just like was so moist. It was unbelievable. As soon as I ate it, it was just heavenly. That was probably the best thing I've had so far out of anything I've eaten was that cake. And it looks like May and Roberta did enjoy their, maybe May, I think, enjoyed a little bit more than Roberta. Is that true?
Yeah, that was not my favorite.
I like your dessert.
I told you guys, May's right. That's the best thing I've had on this cruise, May. What do you think?
I like your dessert.
I know you do.
Better than mine.
And when your mother-in-law asks for some, you all, guys, you got to do it. That's all I can say. Roberta? What do you think about the
It was not my favorite. Like the biscuit, you know, the cookie brisket.
Yeah.
It was dry. It was dry.
That's it right there, yeah.
Yeah, it was dry. It was it was not, the flavor was good, but was dry.
But let's talk about something that was excellent, and that's the service we had tonight.
Yes, the service was
great. I think I already said it a couple times, but once again, these guys, excellent, top notch. Probably some of the best service. And look, as Roberta turns on the light, Lily, our stateroom attendant, she's really cool, from Romania. Jake is chilling right there. Look at him go. His birthday. I can't believe. What the? Guys. That's cool. What is it? An elephant? Or like, I think it's an elephant. He's a cool elephant because he's layering Mickey Ray-Bans, man. That's cool. And Jake, believe it or not, Roberta, what time is it right now?
It's early. 8:40.
I've never seen Jake this tired at 8:40, I don't think, in my life. And if you guys remember our last cruises, right?
Yeah.
Jake, this is the only time Jake gets tired early is on cruise ships. But it's supposed to be the opposite, right? Cruising is supposed to be where you relax and have just a lot of time to just chill. But we're going to find time to chill because this is not a 3-night cruise, guys. No, it's not a 4-night cruise. No, it's not a 5-night cruise. No, it's not a 6-night cruise. It's a 7-nighter. And we're only on, like, we only slept one of those nights. So, lots more to go. I think Jake and May are going to hang back. And Roberta and I, we're going to head out to check out Greece.
Yes,
Greece. Let's do it. Jake has rejoined us. All of a sudden, Roberta and I are heading to the show. And there was Volvo with Jake. And Jake, I guess, Volvo. What happened, Jake? You just said, no, I'm going to the show now. He just changed his mind like that. No, I am not tired anymore. I'm going to the show. Is that how it went?
Yeah.
Yeah.
His birthday went out.
Yeah. For some reason, I went into my bed and then just gained all my energy back.
This happens with Jake. So, and he. If you guys know Meddling World, right? It's us three, man. Look, Roberta's the one who's going to need a nap, but we're always the ones that are all together. So, yeah. Greece was awesome. So far, all the entertainment we've seen on this ship has been really, really good. The one thing I'm gonna say, we left a little bit early because it was freezing in that theater. So if you're gonna go see Greece, bring a coat. And Jake fell asleep after all. So we had to kind of get out of there a little bit earlier, but it was awesome. So, day two has come to an end. I want to thank everybody for watching Meddling World. As you can see, Roberta's already in the room with Jake. Trying to be a little quiet. It's after 11. Thank you so much for watching Meddling World. Please take a moment, hit subscribe. Thank you to all Patreons. And last but not least,
See ya.